Hello, my name's Julian Edgar, and I'm the author of this book, A Century of Car Aerodynamics, The Science and Art of Cars and Airflow. What I want to cover in today's video is the 1958 MG EX181, a fantastically slippery and advanced speed record holder. Let's take a look at it. Wow! This is what I saw. This is what it looked like when I photographed it in a museum in the UK. An extraordinarily advanced looking car. It looks like a solar race car of 20 or 30 or even 40 years later. Amazingly low drag shape. Here are the coolant inlets at the front in the stagnation zone, beautifully positioned. And here are the coolant outlets, the air outlets for the cooling system. And here are the exhaust outlets. And all of them are aimed along the skin of the vehicle. Innovate the boundary layer, keep it attached to the vehicle all the way to the back of the car. Now, they did their testing, their aerodynamic testing, on a model, and this is the model also on display in that museum. Now, notice straight away the model is going to be slipperier than the real car. There are no exhaust outlets, there's no cooling air outlets on the model. How did it fare? 0.12 drag coefficient. Now, the real car is probably a little bit higher than that for the reasons I've just outlined. Frontal area, projected frontal area, just a fraction over 1 square meter. A very, very small car. Now, remember, total drag is drag coefficient multiplied by projected frontal area. And obviously, if you can get both of those values down, then you're going to have an enormously slippery vehicle. You can see here the size of it, the recumbent, semi-recumbent driving position. You can see the mid-mounted motor. And on this particular view, you can also see a fairly large tail fin. Interestingly enough, that tail fin was dropped subsequently. So obviously the car had enough stability without it. It's powered by a supercharged 1.5 litre four-cylinder engine. It was running in a class, a 1.5 litre class, not the outright speed record. And it had an output power of about 216 kilowatts, 290 horsepower. So how fast did it go? Well, in 1957 at Bonneville, it did 395 kilometers an hour, 240, nearly 246 miles an hour. And then they deleted the tail fin, as you can see in this particular shot. And 2 years later, 1959, it did 410 kilometers an hour, just under 255 miles an hour. And you can see in that view why I say it looks like a solar race car of 30, 40 years later. Journalists at the time didn't even know how to describe its shape. They called it a pumpkin seed in shape because they didn't have any better description. A really fantastic car, very, very quick, very, very slippery. It's one of the cars covered in my book, A Century of Car Aerodynamics. I cover land speed record holders, including outright land speed record holders. I cover production cars. I cover some of the concept cars. It's full of fascinating cars in terms of their aerodynamics for both slipperiness and also downforce. The book's available from Amazon in your country. Thank you.